How to connect electrical cables. S, V, Z, W part winding compressors. We need a cutter, Phillips screwdriver, a punch, a hammer, cutter to remove sharp and cutting edges, a 13mm T-wrench or ratchet, a 13mm torque wrench with socket range set to 15Nm. We also need safety helmet, safety goggles, safety gloves, and safety shoes. Attention! Keep and read the instructions manual carefully and always respect the safety warnings indicated. Compressor label check. Carefully read the label on the compressor to size the components of the electrical panel and pay attention to the type of motor indicated and the voltage, MRA, LRA values reported. Carefully read the warnings in the yellow sticker on the junction box and, with the help of the legend, check the oil level contained inside the compressor to ensure it is optimal. How to check the supply status. With a Phillips screwdriver, open the junction box by unscrewing the screws. Attention! Pay attention to the electrical wiring instructions on the back of the junction box cover. Check that the supply status contained inside the junction box is correct. In this case, we find gasket kit, temperature probe, crankcase heater, thermal paste, cable gland, pump pressure switch, connector for valves, a bar kit for electrical connection. Open the various kits contained inside the junction box and place the contents in an orderly manner in order to make a precise and fast electrical connection. How to make a dull electrical connection delta. Open a hole for the cable glands in the desired position by hammering the tip of the slotted screwdriver into the fracture mark. Eliminate blues and sharp edges from the opening to avoid damage on the cables and injuries. Let's position the ground cable. Take the star screw and two washers. Position the ground cable and tighten the screw with a Phillips screwdriver, fixing it as best as possible. Advice: positioning and screwing the ground cable first will allow to have more room for subsequent operations. The electrical terminal plate shows the letters and numbers relating to each individual pin, which can be used as a legend to position the electrical connection bars and power. Take the three bars and place them on pins U1 with Z7, V2 with X8, and W3 with Y9. Place the set of cables inside the drilled hole. Place the three cables on the three pins Z7, X8, and Y9. Take six washers and place them on each pin. Take four nuts and place them on the four pins Y9, W3, B2, and U1. Take the two eyelets for the crewel wiring and place them on the two remaining pins, X8, Z7. Place the two remaining nuts on top of the two rings just placed. Screw everything with a 13mm T-wrench. If a 13mm T-wrench is not available, use a ratchet. Verify the tightening of the nuts is correct by using a torque wrench set to 15Nm. Connect the crew on protection device to the two eyelets previously positioned, inserting the brown fasten into the corresponding pin X8 and the black one into pin Z7. To finalize the connection, wire the crew on protection device to the two thermistor probes. Close the junction box by tightening all the screws of the cover with a Phillips screwdriver or a screwer. How to make part-ring electrical connection. Open the number of holes required to insert the power cable and the cable gland, hammering on the fracture mark with a suitable toe. Eliminate blurs and sharp edges from the opening to avoid damages to the cables and injuries. Place the power cables inside the first hole. Let's position the ground cable. Take the star screw and two washers, position the ground cable and tighten the screw with a Phillips screwdriver, fixing it as best as possible. Advice: positioning and screwing the ground cable first will allow you to have more room for subsequent operations. The electrical terminal plate shows the letters and numbers relating to each individual pin, which can be used as a legend to position the electrical connection bars and power. Place the three power cables on pins Y9, X8 and Z7. Place the second set of power cables inside the second hole. Position the three cables on the remaining three pins U1, V2 and W3. In order to position them by creating the pair of corresponding pins U1 with Z7, V2 with X8 and W3 with Y9. Advice: we recommend using three different colors on the power cable: brown with brown, gray with gray, black with black. This will allow a simplified visual wiring check. Take the remaining six washers and place them on each pin. Take four nuts and place them on the four pins Y9, W3, V2 and U1. Take the two eyelets for the crew on wiring and place them on the two remaining pins X8, Z7. Place the two remaining nuts on top of the two rings just placed. Screw everything with a 13mm T-wrench. If a 13mm T-wrench is not available, use a ratchet. Check that the tightening of the nuts is correct by using a torque wrench set to 15Nm. Connect the crew on protection device to the two eyelets previously positioned, inserting the brown fasten into the corresponding pin Z7 and the black one into pin X8. To conclude the connection, wire the crew on protection device to the two thermistor probes. Close the junction box by tightening all the screws of the cover with a Phillips screwdriver or a screwer. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and discover all Frascold's video trainings. Frascold, blue is better.